Okay, here is today's fun adventure. We're gonna auto-tune the Emax. It's a little breezier than it was last night when I tested this, but there's sun up now so we can see it. So this is the Emax 280 Pro with the built-in Skyline 32, which is basically their version of a Naze, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's your standard clean flight board, if you will, and it's running the new dRonin pre-release here. So we'll go ahead and arm and just get up in the air, and this is in pure acro mode right now. I'm going to switch into horizon mode to stable first, and now I'm going to enable auto-tune. And you'll see it start doing its dance. And we're going to dance for about 60 seconds here. It's not super exciting, but it's kind of fun to watch it jiggle and wiggle. I'm flying here under the carport just in case something goes crazy. And to try and get away from that wind out there. Of course, I'm getting my own turbulence, which isn't probably going to help things, but I've had good luck auto-tuning here before, so I'm not too worried about it. And pretty soon here, we should be starting to ease up. There we go. So now what we're going to do is we're going to land and disarm. And that has saved our auto-tune, which we will now go inside and review. Because actual tuning is calculated in the GCS on the computer. So I will plug in. And GCS, we're on the big screen today, so hopefully you can see this. It doesn't auto-detect the Naze boards because of how they work. So we'll have to manually connect. And we're up. We'll go to the auto-tune tab. And there's our results. We have results. Tau of 21.3 milliseconds. Pretty darn good. Not horrible at all. Noise is higher than it was on my tests last night. Not unsurprising with the extra wind. I'm going to go ahead and apply those values. And I'm going to go ahead and share my results. This is a new feature of dRonin compared to Tau. My weight is about 580 grams or so. It's... I haven't actually weighed it exactly as it is, but that's roughly the weight. We're on a, oh, not 2800, 280, three cells. These are Emax 2204, 2400 kV motors. These are Emax blheli 14.2 with, damped light enabled, and these were the Dell 6x4.5 props. And we'll just put in an observation here of little windier than last time. And we will send that to the database, which submits it to a website set up just for this. We can also copy to our clipboard, which gives us a nice version that can be shared in forums and IRC and other places. But we've applied this. I'm just going to come back here and check my stabilization tab. And you can see my integral changed quite a bit, which isn't surprising. I'm going to apply. That is pretty big integral there. We're going to see how that goes, though. Not that it's only pitch, but we'll let it save. Now we will go back outside and we'll fly it. Okay, back into acro mode. Arm. That looks pretty darn good to me. Feels pretty darn good too. Let's see here. Yeah, that feels pretty darn nice. I can't complain about that tune one bit. That is the smoothest I've had this guy flying. Let's see, a nice fast yaw here, how it does compared to what was happening to me on beta flight. Still have a little overshoot on the yaw, but autotune doesn't really tune yaw, I'm pretty sure, so not horrible there. Yeah, that feels really, really nice to me. I'm very happy with that tune. I have zero complaints about this right now, other than that I couldn't find a spotter this morning to fly with me. And that was me being silly. Got a little mixed up there. Hey, no problems. This frame really does take quite a beating. And I can also, just to try here, let's go ahead and pop it in. Horizon. I'm a little off. I should probably retune the calibration. It wants to go a little crooked in horizon. Oh. Doesn't want to go all the way over in horizon right now for some reason. Not sure what's going on there. I mean, we're definitely set up well enough to flip nice. I'm not sure why Horizon is acting a little wonky on me today, but in acro mode, we're feeling really good. I am definitely happy with this tune. This is by far the best I've had this quad flying, and I have zero complaints. So pre-release dRonin is a big win for me right now. Can't wait to see where it goes. There's lots of exciting stuff coming, and can't wait to fly more of it. Now to go try and find someone to do some FPV with me this morning. See you later.